Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to manage iCloud storage on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you have a limited amount of iCloud storage, depending upon how much you pay for. How do you manage what's on there and know if you're getting close to your limit? Well, on the Mac, you would go to System Preferences and then click on Apple ID at the top. Then look on the left for iCloud and click that. Now at the bottom, you're going to see a little graph here that shows you how you're using iCloud storage. Now this is a demo account, so I'm just using the free 5 gigs. Here you could see little areas for photos and videos, documents, messages, mail, and then the available space. But to get really detailed information, click Manage. Now this is just going to give you an overview of the things that you have on iCloud. It's not going to give you the details you want, but it's a good place to start. So here you can see very typical results where the top two items are photos and other documents. After all, both photos and documents are large files that take up a lot of space. So in this demo account, I have 400 or so megs of photos. Of course, in my real account, I have many gigs of photos. If I click here, you don't really get much additional information. You get that there are 180 photos and 3 videos stored, and all I could do is turn it off. To really see the photos I have stored, I would go to the Photos app. And in here, I could see at the bottom of all photos, it shows me the same thing, 180 photos, 3 videos. And this is where I can figure out what I've got and if maybe there are things I can get rid of. I can look through and get rid of duplicates. I can go to Media Types here, for instance, and see things like videos, which are typically going to be a lot larger than photos. And I can manage things. Now, if, say, I want to clear some things off, I could go through photos and delete photos. One of the things I like to do to save space on iCloud is to not store very many videos in my photos library. I like to leave my photos library as just photos, and I like to put videos just as files on my hard drive, perhaps not even in iCloud, but stored locally or maybe in an external drive. Now, back in System Preferences here, Other Documents is telling you basically about the files that you have stored in iCloud Drive. Now you also have some other categories here below. For instance, I've got one here for Numbers, another for Keynote. These aren't really any different than Other Documents. But if you look in the Finder and you go to iCloud Drive, you'll see you have a variety of folders here, including your Documents folder, which is probably where you have most of your stuff. But there are also special folders created for some apps, like for Keynote. If I look in Keynote here, I have a few files in that special folder. You may not use that folder for anything, or you may use it to store all your Keynote files. It's really up to you. Same thing for Numbers. I have a bunch of Numbers files stored in here. This being a demo account, I find it easy to save little demo Numbers files into this folder. So now when I look here in System Preferences at, say, Numbers, you can see it's 7.4 megs. That's the equivalent to what's in this folder here. I have all these files. If I do Command A to select all and then Command Option I to bring up the inspector, you could see 7.8 megs of files. So it's approximately the same amount, just measured a little differently. However, I know I have other Numbers files that are stored in iCloud Drive in Documents, and that number would be a lot bigger if it was all Numbers files. So when looking at what's in other documents, mostly what you're going to see here should be the things that you've got inside your Documents folder in iCloud Drive. If you want to manage what's in there, then naturally you would go into your Documents folder, look around, maybe archive some things you don't need, maybe delete some files that you don't need anymore, and manage these files just like regular files. And then getting rid of any of these would, of course, decrease the amount of iCloud storage you're using. Now, if you want to trim what documents you have in iCloud Drive, in the Finder, go to iCloud Drive either by clicking on it in the left sidebar or using Go iCloud Drive. And then here you'll see everything in iCloud Drive switched to List View. And now you'll see size here on the right. It's usually blank. But if you choose View, Show View Options, or Command J, check, calculate all sizes, you'll see sizes now for each of those folders. Sort by size by clicking there. And now I can see my Documents folder takes up the bulk of that. I can expand the Documents folder and I could see what inside that takes up the most. So I can see my Example Files folder is the largest. I can go down to that and see, oh yeah, I've got a Photoshop document that's taking up 38 megs of my 170 megs right there. So maybe that's something I don't need anymore. Maybe I can archive that. You just basically use this list view and keep digging down into the different folders to see what you've got. It's pretty quick and easy to do, And if you seem to be using a lot more space than you thought, this is a really quick way to get to the bottom of it. Usually you see the files that are taking up the most space right away and you really get to understand a little bit better what files you've got and what's taking up space and come up with a strategy for maybe clearing some of that off. Now you're also going to see other apps listed here like iMovie, Health, Shortcuts, other third-party apps, Reminders. These are all going to use some storage space to store their data. Typically these are going to be pretty small. So you're not going to want to worry about these. I mean, obviously, if you really wanted to trim the amount of data that Reminders was storing, you would go into Reminders and delete old Reminders or ones you don't use, or maybe even attachments that you've added to Reminders. But in most cases, if you're trying to clean up your iCloud storage, you really wouldn't bother with these smaller apps. The further you get down this list, the smaller the numbers get, and the less effect cleaning up stuff in them is going to have. Now, one thing I've got here is Messages, and you may see Messages all the way up near the top. I only have 9 megs in here in this demo account. If I look in the Messages app, you can see the reason for those 9 megs is I've recently received a couple of photo attachments. And since in Messages, in Preferences under iMessage, I've got Enable Messages in iCloud, it's using iCloud to sync my messages across all my devices, which means these photos and any other attachments are stored inside of iCloud. So if you have a lot of photos, then it's going to add up and Messages is going to take up a lot of space. There's no real good way to get rid of these. You can select any one and hit delete and it will delete one of these messages or the attachment. You can control click on it and select delete as well to delete a message. If you click on the I button here at the top and then you scroll down, you could see photos and you can control click, two finger click on a trackpad or right click on a mouse and delete a single photo or attachment. But there's no good way to delete lots of them. One thing you can do is in Messages Preferences under General, you can set Keep Messages instead of Forever to only 30 days or 1 year. So older messages will automatically get deleted. I know some people like to keep their messages around forever though. But if you're using a lot of storage and messages, you may want to create a new habit for yourself. And that's when you receive a photo or attachment from somebody. After you view that message, then maybe save it. You can see if I control click on it, I can actually add to my photos library, for instance, or I could drag and drop this out to the Finder to save it somewhere and then delete it from messages. It's not easy to do if you've got thousands of these going back into the past, but if you start it as a habit now not to let photos and attachments accumulate in the Messages app, then you can really avoid having messages take up a lot of space in your iCloud storage. Another thing you may see here is Backups. And for me, it's all the way at the bottom because I don't have any stored for this particular account. But in my regular account, I would see the backup for my iPad and my iPhone here. This is the iCloud backup, but it's one of the most useful things that you could do with iCloud is to let it back up your iPhone and iPad. An iCloud backup is so valuable. If your iPhone is lost or stolen, you can get a new one and pick up right where you're left off. So while you can select a backup here and use the minus button to delete it, it's not a good place to cut corners. You should let your devices back up to iCloud because that's one of the best uses for iCloud storage. Now, if you are running out of storage space here, you want to click Buy More Storage, and this is where you go to upgrade your account. I know a lot of people don't like to spend even 99 cents a month on a service, but Macs are expensive computers. iPhones are expensive iPhones, and iPads are expensive tablets. If you want to get the most out of them, you really need to spend a little bit on iCloud storage. Otherwise, it's kind of like getting a nice car, but then refusing to ever drive it on the highway. You're not getting the most out of it. Now, I know a lot of people say, I don't want to see a 99 cent or a $2.99 cent charge on my credit card bill every month. And no, you don't need to do that. If you go into Media and Purchases and Manage Your Account, it'll go to the Mac App Store. And in the area where you manage your account, there's a section for add money to your account. You can add money to your Apple account in increments here and it'll deduct from that. So say you have the $2.99 plan and maybe every once in a while you rent a movie or buy an app, you can add $50 or $100 to your account and it'll just keep pulling out of that. So it's kind of like having an annual plan, but even better than that since it covers other Apple purchases as well. So I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.